Kenya was represented by the special envoy to South Sudan, Dr. Kalonzo Musyoka, while South Sudan was represented by the Minister of the Presidency, Benjamin Marrell. The British delegation was led by its ambassador in Juba, John Bartex, the Norwegian special envoy to South Sudan, Andrea Stesten, and the U.S. charge defense based in Juba, David Reze. He observed that the sanctions imposed on the neighboring country were wrong because they create a vacuum. He called on the leaders and stakeholders to work together in lifting the sanctions. President Museveni said he would be pleased to host the retreat, adding that it was necessary to pass 6 pending laws before the end of December. He said the strategic issue is how to build prosperity for the people of South Sudan. He also advised them to focus on elections, saying it's the only medicine for peace and stability.
We had, and the retreat will come, and we shall see. I am ready for the retreat, and but also do something about the embargo. The ones who put the embargo, I don't think it is necessary, because we can get peace even if there is no embargo.
President disclosed that when UPDF attacked the terrorists in DRC Congo early this week, the people of Uganda jubilated because Ugandans are tired of terrorism.
Northern Nigeria, those Boko Haram were, I think... That's your name.
Yes.
He was part of this army. He retired. He had been in the army of the British, you can imagine. He joined us here. He was like our grandfather, but he was with us. It's very crucial. How they have been messing up Congo?
The South Sudan Minister of Presidency expressed his condolences to the president upon the loss of lives around Kampala during the recent bomb explosions. According to the Kenyan Special Envoy to South Sudan, Uganda and Sudan are the guarantors of peace process in South Sudan. Story by Juliet Namwaya for the news.